It's the ancient art of glass blowing, practiced at the labs now by just 6 men, 3 from Area 20 and these 3 from Area 10. Supervisor Bert Hennion, who's been a glass blower here for 27 years. Larry Alexander, who's been here 23 years, and Dave Dorsey, 30 years. They make lab equipment for researchers in the chemistry and physics departments and occasionally do work for other groups. Home Bell and Indian Hill also send special projects. Glassblowers did a lot of work for the Telstar project, but since then, demand for their services has declined. So I asked Bert Hennion, is glassblowing a dying art here at the labs?
It seems to be. There are less places all the time that are using great quantities of glass, and the type of work has changed over the past few years. A lot of the glass apparatus we used to make is being made out of metal now, metal vacuum stations.
So transistors have made an impact, the semiconductor industry?
Some, yes. The large power tubes and things like that are still made out of glass, but all the small stuff is being replaced by transistors. Radio tubes and things like that are not, just don't make them anymore. They very seldom train glass blowers anymore. If you want to be a glass blower, you just have to go and work in a glass shop where they do the type of work. And you probably, if you want to learn everything about it, you'd have to work there a couple years, go to someplace else where they do a different type of work, learn what they do, making there, and do that several times, then you could be a complete glass blower where you could do everything.
Could you tell me a little about the work you were just doing? What do you call it, and what did it involve?
Well, I was making a glass-to-metal seal. The metal is Kovar. The glass I was putting on it matches the expansion of the metal.
Notice you blowing through the tube. So you actually do glass blowing here. It's not just forming at a lathe.
That's right. Once the glass is hot, it'll collapse if you don't blow it and keep the shape you want. Well, that's why we have to blow to form whatever shape we want. The only thing the lathe is for is to hold the glass for you. But we have to shape it or make anything we want out of it. Long, short, whatever.
So their work has changed. Half their time is spent making equipment out of quartz for high temperature experiments, and their numbers have dwindled. Yet as you watch them work, you hope there will always be a need for glass blowers.